Hey everyone, Kevin here. Today, I'll show you exactly how to make an automatic table of contents in Microsoft Word. Let's dive in. Here I am in Microsoft Word, and I would like to include a table of contents in this document that I'm writing about the Kevin Cookie Company. I would like to include all these different section headers that I have throughout my document and the associated page number. But I don't want to have to do any of that manually. We just don't have time for that. Click into your document where you would like to insert your table of contents. Then, up on the top tabs, let's click on the option titled References. Then, over on the left-hand side, we have an option for a table of contents. Let's click on this. Here we have a few different options, but let's go with Automatic Table 1. Click on this. This opens up a prompt saying, creating a table of contents. Start by applying a heading style from the Styles Gallery to the selected text. Basically, we need to tell Word what items we would like to include in our table of contents. Let's click on OK. And if we scroll down just a little bit, here I have my first header that says how it all started in 2006. I would like this to be the first item in my table of contents. So let's highlight this text. Then up on the top tabs, go over to the option titled Home. And right in the center, we have a section for styles. Let's click on this and we have all these different styles. Let's select heading style number one. If you hover over there, you see heading one. I'll click on that and that applies that heading one style to that text. That looks good. Now let's go back up to our table of contents. And right here, when you click on it, you have the option that says update table. Let's click on that and look at that. It pulls this heading into our table of contents and it also shows the associated page number over on the right-hand side. Now, of course, a table of contents isn't really that useful with just one item. So let's go through the document and find some more headers right here. I'd like this to be another item in my table of contents. I'll highlight this text and let's apply heading number one. I'll scroll through. Here's another one. Let me highlight that. Let me apply the heading one style to that as well. And then go through the rest of your document and apply the heading one style to all of your other sections in your document that you would like to have appear as part of your table of contents. I'll do that right now. Once you finish, scroll all the way back up to the top of your document where you have your table of contents. And it looks like we don't have any of the additional headings yet. Click into your table of contents. And once again, we have to update the table. When you click on it, let's select this option that says update table. When I click on that, here we have the option to update page numbers only or update the entire table. Let's update the entire table, click on OK, and there we now have all the additional items added with their page numbers. A few things to be aware of when you're working with a table of contents. If your page numbers change, you'll have to update the table. As an example, let's go down here and instead of having this on the first page, I'd rather have it start on the second page. Let's go up to Insert and let's insert a page break. So now how it all started in 2006 starts on the second page, but here it refers to page number one in the table of contents. I'll select the table of contents. Let's go up to update table. And over here, I'll select update page numbers only. And when I click on OK, here it now updates to reflect that it's on page number two. With the table of contents, you can edit and update text directly in line. For example, instead of just saying contents, why don't we call this the table of contents? Also, here it says how it all started in 2006. Maybe I just want to say how it all started. I could delete that text. One thing to be aware of, if I scroll down just a little bit, it won't update the text in line. So let's undo that last change. Let's bring back in 2006 into the table of contents. Instead, let's go down and let's update it here. I'll change it to how it all started. But if we go up to the table of contents here, it hasn't updated. Here again, we have to update the table. Let's click on this. And for these different options, let's make sure to update the entire table. We're not just updating the page numbers. Click on OK. And here it now reflects the heading that I have down below in my document. So remember, anytime you want to update one of the items in your table of contents, make sure to do it in your document down below. And then that update will reflect in your table of contents once you update it. So far, we've just been using the default table of contents, but you can also completely customize it. To do that, click into your table of contents, and then we get this overlay. Let's click on this dropdown, and at the very bottom, we have the option to remove the table of contents. Let's click on that, and now the table of contents and all that work is gone. But let's take a look at how you can customize it. Up on the top tabs, let's click on References, and over on the left-hand side, again, let's click on Table of Contents. And here we have all the different automatic tables. At the very bottom, we also have the option to insert a custom table of contents. Let's select this. This opens up a dialog that gives us even more control over our table of contents. Here, you can decide whether you want to show page numbers or no page numbers, where you want to align those page numbers, and how you would like to separate them from your different titles. Here, you can choose a few different options. You could also decide how many levels you would like to show in your table of contents. In this example, we've just been using the style heading 1, and we've just included that as part of our table of contents. But you could also apply style heading 2 or heading 3, and you could show additional levels in your table of contents. For now, let's just go with the default and click on OK. And there we now have a table of contents again. One thing to call out, if you insert a custom table of contents, if you click into it, you won't get that overlay that lets you update the table. So to update your table of contents, if it's custom, go up to References, and here you have the option to update the table. By using styles, we were able to insert an automated table of contents, but they also have lots of other benefits. Let's say, for example, you want to update how all of your different headings look. Up on top, I'll click on the Home tab, and here I see my different styles. I can right-click on this, and let's modify this style. Let's say, for example, I'd like to make it a little bit larger. Over here, I'll select the font size, and let's go with 24, then click on OK, and that updates the style here. And if I scroll down a little bit more, you'll see it updated the style throughout the entire document. Another thing I like, you can also expand and collapse all of your different chapters. Here, for example, let's say I want to collapse this chapter. I can click on this icon and that collapses it. Let's go up on top. I could also collapse that one. So that way it's really easy to get through your document. Lastly, this is one of my favorites. Up on top, let's click on the View tab. Then we could turn on something called the Navigation Pane. And here you see all the different headings used throughout your document. And the beautiful thing, if you want to quickly navigate to any one of these headings, simply click on it and that'll bring you directly to that point in your document. So you get so much power beyond just a table of contents by using styles. Along with using the Navigation Pane to navigate through your document, if we go right back up to the top where we have our table of contents, you can Ctrl Click on any one of the items in this table of contents. So let's say we'd like to read more about the customer falling into the chocolate river. Press the Ctrl key and then click on that item, and that'll bring you to that specific point in your document. And there you have it. Now your readers won't get lost in your document anymore. If this video helped you stay organized, please consider subscribing, and I'll catch you in the next one.